no obstacles. Climbing is all about obstacles. Climbing and life have something in common. The never-ending process of falling and learning how to get back up, stronger than you were before. When you accomplish that rigorous obstacle, you feel the adrenaline, the dopamine flow through you. That incredible sense of accomplishment that seems so fulfilling. This feeling that you can get from climbing, and in general with parkour. What? Huh? Did he just put those two vastly different words together? Well, don't worry, dear viewer, because they are the same thing. Now, I know you may be confused, and so was I when I was trying to overcome this incredible difficult obstacle in the documentary that you are about to indulge in. Now, I'm not trying to say that anything can be parkour. It's about jumping or climbing to the one surface or another, from point A to point B. Now, I know that what you may be thinking. What am I really talking about? Well, they're actually connected through many forms of history. So, let's ask Ben to tell us a little more about that.
These sports both originated in France. Parkour was first made by a restless teenager boy by the name of David Bell. This boy was inspired by his father Raymond, who was a firefighter and died tragically in 1990 as David was a young child. As a kid, David was told his father was like Tarzan or Spider-Man, and this invigorated David to be like his father. So he created the word parkour and started jumping from building to building like just like his father. A very touching story. 10 years before Raymond's death, a light bulb went off in a man named Francois Savigny's brain. He thought that instead of making rock climbing holds from rock or wood, he'd mold them together from plastic and put a bolt hole in the middle so that the holds could easily be moved around. It was a genius concept, one that would bring indoor rock climbing as we now know it. Now, I wish these were more connected than just their origin in France, but sadly, that is just not true. I guess the French just really enjoyed finding new, innovative ways to jump and climb in the 1900s.
So, my people, have I not convinced you enough? Well, today, I'm at the 13th annual Women's Parkour Movement to get some, you know, real perspectives on what people think parkour truly is. I've already told you how they're linked through history and location. So, I mean, what more really is there to prove? But I guess since you asked for more, let's go.
The true definition of parkour in my eyes is really the art of the motion. Parkour can also be huge for keeping you safe.
I think parkour is a mindset, a movement from point A to point B.
It helps me feel young. It helps me feel connected to youth culture.
Working on balancing is parkour, because a lot of times the most efficient way would just be going up the stairs, and that's not fun. We'd rather just jump over the stairs than find other ways to climb over something.
It is how you take something so simple as jumping on a wall to make it your own.
My experience at the Women's Parkour Movement was very interesting. There are many new and unique perspectives on the sport of parkour. However, I need to know from professionals, people who have spent their life devoted to the sport, which led me to American Ninja Warrior, which was started in 2009 and features thousands of contestants who compete on obstacle courses, some of which are centered around parkour. Many of them train at one of the biggest parkour gyms in Greenville, Motive School of Movement. So I interviewed with a few of these experienced ninjas to truly find out if indoor rock climbing and bouldering are forms of parkour.
Hi y'all, my name is Ryan Stratus. I'm from Greenville, South Carolina. About to be 40, I've been an American Ninja Warrior for 11 seasons and getting ready to be on there again for season 15 coming up here soon. The whole debate of parkour, what it is, and the differentiations between that and free running, you get a lot of back and forth. I've been there. What all could fall under the umbrella that is known as parkour, rock climbing? You're trying to be efficient from point A on the ground to point B at the top of the ceiling. So that's a bit of a stretch, I think, in that regard. So I don't think you can call rock climbing parkour.
My name is Booty Cothran. I am from Possum Kingdom, South Carolina. I've been a competitor on Ninja Warrior for 8 seasons now, going on 9th coming up. Where I describe parkour as just kind of creative, free-flowing movement from point A to point B, however somebody wants to decide to do that, and whatever works for them, and the artistic way that they want to do that. But I could certainly see the perspectives of It would be a stretch for me to call that parkour, though. Yeah.
I'm Brett Sims. I am 36, 37 years old from Greenville, South Carolina. This is my hometown. This is where I grew up, and this is where our business is. For me, parkour is a movement-based sport where you just use your body to navigate through your environment. There are different aspects and different things you can do with parkour. You can be strictly about efficient movement and do like what we call actual, you know, parkour, and it's about moving through your environment efficiently, getting over obstacles from point A to point B as quickly as possible, basically. Borrow from gymnastics and martial arts and break dancing, and anything you want to do is okay with parkour. And I think that that's one of the reasons a lot of people really like it, is because there's no box. You can do literally whatever you want, and all you need is your body. So actually, it's interesting with rock climbing, especially with new bouldering style competitions, you know, short routes without ropes. There are a lot of parkour elements that are being implemented into new competition style climbing. But I think really the difference here is probably more rules with competition climbing like that. There is still a point A and point B. You know, I love to climb, and a lot of people who love to do parkour also love to climb because it does share some similar types of movement.
You know what they say, third time's the charm. And you know what, I will take it to prove that rock climbing and indoor bouldering are forms of parkour. Even if AI itself tells me that indoor rock climbing and bouldering are not forms of parkour, this guy owns the place, meaning basically that his opinion has the most value. While making this documentary, I began straying away from the central question and found myself immersed in these different communities. Blockhaven, where I filmed most of my climbing footage, had a very vibrant community, one in which my brother and sister are a part of, and I had always wondered why this was so important to them. Parkour and indoor rock climbing are some of the most rapidly growing sports in Greenville. I truly believe that this is because of these communities surrounding these gyms and movements. So whether you disagree or agree with me, I hope through this documentary, you can see how these different places impact people.
A place that people truly believe is their home. Thank you, and parkour out.
I've had the opportunity to see community form at multiple different gyms now, and I think the one here is really special just because you see so many different people and different types of people. There's a lot of like openness and just people welcoming each other in here with this community that you don't always see.
Well, the community is great in the Ninja Warrior world. It's all supportive. Everybody's trying to do hard stuff all the time. So you get that bonding really quick through the mutual suffering that this sport is all about. We're all trying to do the same things, and it's real challenging. And I think that's what really causes the cohesion in the unit to come around so quickly.
I love the level of collaboration that happens. When I train with the guys, we're still collaborating. It's just, it has a different vibe, it feels different. And when I'm training with people that are like me, similar skill level, the collaboration just feels so much more in sync, and we get to build off each other and have a lot of fun.
Ninja Warrior is honestly one of those really cool atmospheres and communities. We all want everyone to succeed. It's more fun to go onto that next stage with your friends. So everyone's always coming back and being like, oh man, that felt a little different, or like, you know, watch out for that, or you know, you need to work on this technique, you know.
A diversity of size, of ethnicity, of age, of family types and dynamics. And so when you walk in, you are bound to find your people. And they just pull you in, you come every time, and I think because you're doing a sport that is so in tune with your own body, it helps you become in tune with the people around you, which creates such a beautiful depth and relationship.